Suppose the goal is to describe particles that are really fast and therefore behave relativistically. The approach we will take here is the Klein-Gordon equation. Many physicists around 1926 tried to describe the movement of electrons. Although the Klein-Gordon equation fails to do exactly that, it was published by Oscar Klein and Walter Gordon in order to describe relativistic electrons. That was around the same time as Schrödinger published his equation, which is purely non-relativistic, but applicable to electrons. The Klein-Gordon equation is still very important, as it turned out to describe spinless relativistic particles, such as pions and the Higgs particle. These were not known at the time, but are bosonic particles which are part of the current standard model of particle physics. The most important aspect in the ansatz is that the relativistic dispersion relation must be followed. A dispersion assigns each momentum p of the particle with mass m a certain energy e, like e equals p squared over 2m, only this is not relativistic. The relativistic energy-momentum relation is a result of Minkowski space-time with four space coordinates, where time is the zeroth component and c is the speed of light. The four momentum consists of E over C and P. Note the sign change in the spatial coordinates when pulling indices according to the metric used. The inner product of the momentum is a Lorentz scalar. Therefore, it is always m squared c squared, no matter in which frame of reference. And it is equally given by using the four momentum above. Rearranging a bit yields the final expression. In quantum mechanics, observables are recovered by applying operators to the wave function. So we exchange the energy by its operator, which contains the time derivative, or equally in a four-vector notation, where the derivative is taken with respect to the zeroth component of the space vector, which is ct. We also replace the momentum by its operator, which includes the derivative with respect to the spatial coordinates. So e squared minus p squared times c squared minus m squared times c to the fourth becomes minus h bar squared times c squared times twice the zeroth derivative. And because exactly the same arises for the spatial derivative, we can combine it into a fourth derivative minus the rest, which is m squared times c to the fourth. And all this acting on the wave function psi must be zero. This is often written in terms of the inverse reduced Compton wavelength, kappa, defined as mc over h bar. You will notice that this is a wave equation, for which we can easily write down a solution. In the case of a real scalar field psi, it is a plane wave with some amplitude a and phase theta moving in space given by a cosine. Here again the frequency and the wave vector are connected. Suppose we put the wave function in a box and apply periodic boundary conditions. So when the wave function travels the distance L, it goes over into its origin, which can travel either left or right. The most general solution is thus given by a superposition of such plane waves by summing over all possible wave vectors. Please like and subscribe. That's pretty much it for the Klein-Gordon equation and its solution.